After my presentation yesterday, I had a young lady from Winnipeg come up, a player, and she thought that I was ragging on girls basketball, and I said no. I was just explaining my girls' team that I'm coaching. I coach very high level girls. My last, when Kim Smith was in grade 12, like the best player on our national team, she phoned me up at Christmas time and said, "I got to get better. Can I play against your point guard?" And we had a point guard that went to Simon Fraser and played for 5 years. And so I said, yeah, and I was coaching boys at the time. And so she came in and we played one-on-one for an hour every day on Sunday afternoons. And in the first 2-3 months, she got killed. By June, the games were a toss-up, right? That's how much she improved. And that's how much she adjusted to playing against a different speed level, against a different length and that sort of stuff. So by no means was I trashing girls basketball. I was just saying that my team is somewhat weak, okay? So we're going to get better, though. We're going to get way better. My topic today is handling pressure. So I'm going to talk about a lot of things. In Drew's presentation today about the five attacks of screens, in all the years I've coached at every university in BC, I've coached a national team. I probably, in my 41 years, have had four guys or four girls, like four people in 41 years, that could shag their man off a ball screen. So ball screen offense is great if you've got people that can use ball screens. My national team this last summer, we didn't have a girl. Our point guards could not utilize ball screen. We didn't have ball screen set in our whole offensive package, right? So, Tanya said it best. I think your job as a coach is to see the players that you have and develop an offense around the players that you have, their strengths and weaknesses. You cannot just go and say, we're going to run ball screen, because it'll be disastrous. But everybody has to handle pressure. Guys, give me three guys up here right now. Okay? So we're going to start this by just a simple cutting drill. So somebody take the ball out of bounds. Somebody line up here, guys. One guy right here and one guy right behind him. Okay. So we're going to just right behind him. Okay. So we're going to cut you to here, okay? So throw the ball. Okay, immediately you got to square up and see the whole court going that way, okay? You have to go down this way, and you have to come back to the ball in the middle of the floor on this side, so the crack of your bum is dissecting the hoop. You have to trail, and you have to get in a position where the crack of your bum is dissecting the middle of the hoop. So you pass it to him. You may be a little bit higher. You pass it to him. Now you got to go and make sure the crack of your bum gets to the middle of the hoop. Okay, square up. Pass it to him. Okay. So that's what you're going to do offensively. Guys, give me three guys guarding them. So go back down here, guys. We're not trying to score. We're just trying to get open. And if you watched yesterday, us passing the ball against pressure, and you watched Drew today, that's the first thing you can't do. So, guys, we're going to allow the first pass, the first catch. So allow the you guys got to set up in a tandem. So let's talk about where you want to set up. Always want to be above the three-point line. So, guys, move back. Okay. You get first cut, and you're going to let him catch. Okay. Now, stop. You have no dribble. So you've got to get up, and you can do it. You got to, don't foul him, but you can pressure the ball. You've got to get and come back and get open somewhere in the middle of the floor with the crack of your butt to the ball. Okay? So pass it. The moment you catch it, you got to hit that guy coming back. There's no dribble. The moment you catch it, you got to try to hit in the post. Okay? Okay, come on back, guys. Now, I'm going to make a prediction. These guys will be awful at this. Okay? And I'll tell you why, because it's a very hard drill. Really hard drill. But if you can't handle pressure and you can't pass through pressure, then it doesn't make much sense. Okay, let's go. Pretty good. Switch around. Not bad. Now, hey, guys, go back. Like, different team on offense. Same team on offense. Okay, defensively, you guys were the shit. Okay? Like, really? They can't dribble, and you can't put pressure on? And we've got a guy that should... And you're the same size as me. We should be in a circus, right? We're midgets. Like, you're not a midget. I'm a midget. Okay? Okay? So, like, look at this guy just made a pass on you, and he's a midget. Okay? Okay, now get up on the ball. Okay, allow the first pass. Allow the first pass. Allow the first pass. Get up! 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 Okay, go again. Okay, you got to follow and get your butt to the crack of the rim. Okay, why do you guys let why do you let them catch? They're scared? Okay, that's a good answer. Hey, why let them catch? Don't let them come back to the ball. Okay, let's go. Get up, get up. Don't let them come back. Don't let them come back. Come on back. Who was that to? You're throwing, like, he's like 5'4", and you threw it up to the guy about, needs to be about 7'3". Go back. Okay, now let's go again. Okay, let's go. Now, guys, this is it. Now this becomes way more difficult, right? Don't let him catch. Okay. Pressure, pressure, pressure. Get open. Get open, get open, get open. Pressure, turn, square, square, square. Okay, play right from there. Pressure, pressure, pressure. Don't turn your back. Don't turn your back. Good job. Square up, square up, square up. Okay. That's a pretty good pass. Okay, now. So you have to handle pressure, and there's different ways to handle pressure. Guys, give me a line a line right here. Give me another ball. Guys, throw me another ball. Okay. Here's another way to deal with pressure. You have a ball. You're right here. Give me a guy's line right up without a ball. Okay, third guy without a ball. Give me another guy with a ball. Fourth guy with a ball. No, give me you. You're going to be here. Fourth guy, line up. Okay. So here, you have to be able to pass under pressure. So I want you to dribble as hard as you can to the foul line extended wing. Okay? But don't pick the ball up. You're chasing them and put pressure on the ball in the wing. So go. Okay. Okay, now hold a second, hold a second, hold a second, hold a second. Woo! Okay, just stay there for a second. Okay. You go this way. Yes, sprint. Okay, now you got to be able to pass under pressure without picking the ball up when he is able to cut. Don't cut until he can see you make a cut. And you're going to make a hard cut. You're going to play live defense on him. Okay, you have to make the pass. Okay, let's go back again. Okay, so this requires vision, requires timing, and requires being able to handle pressure on the ball. Okay, let's go. Stop, stop, stop. Come on back. Okay, this is my bad instruction. You have to stay foul line extended. You don't pick it up. You got to be able to contain. You got to be able to handle the ball here, and handle the pressure. And wait for his cut. Okay? Now you can use that front rollover crossover we did yesterday. Okay, let's go. Keep the ball alive. Okay? Okay, go again. Okay, now try not to turn your back. So you can never lose vision of the basket or your teammate. Okay? Okay. So it looks like a simple drill, but it's very difficult. Because when you made the pass, it was late and it got tipped, right? Okay, you guys give it a try. Okay. Good, right idea. Pass got tipped, right? So go again, guys. So what you're going to do now, guys, is one group's going this way. As soon as they're finished, the other group's taking the ball to that side. Okay, let's go. I didn't say anything. Next group's going right away. Let's go. Let's go. Okay? Okay, so that's just a drill with timing, passing, and cutting that all relates to pressure. You can alter that drill. Now, you go to the sideline full speed, but you're not being guarded. You're not being guarded. Okay, now, second person go help side defense. Third person go that side. Okay, you're guarding him. Okay, now, foul line extended. Don't get too deep. You got to make a cut. You got to be weak side help. We got to deliver the ball. Okay, let's go. Why do you keep looking at me? Okay. Like, I want you to pass to your teammate. Okay. He's trying to get open, right? I love you. You got the greatest expressions, okay? What the hell? My teammate just let me down. Okay? Okay, now you got your help side defense. Your help side defense. Okay? Cut, hit him, bang, boom. And then you guys would play one-on-one. Okay? So, just a couple drills out of pressure that you, just simple drills that you don't think about. I want to show you something else too, I'll forget. Come on down here, guys. Give me some new guys. Give me the ball out of bounds. Guy on offense here, and being face guarded. Being face guarded. So I need five guys. So everybody else off the court. Okay. So right now we won't even guard the ball. Okay? So you're off, yeah. Okay, so be a little higher. So if teams, this is not really handling pressure, this is pressure. I'm going to talk about this later in my next presentation, but if you want like screen on you, so go screen, get shoulder to shoulder defensively. Get shoulder to shoulder defensively. Go shoulder to shoulder. He's off on offense. He's your defensive partner.
Oh.
No, get shoulder to shoulder. Okay? If you do that, you take away every screening action. And you just switch everything. So, just that simple thing. Go shoulder to shoulder on any screening action. So let's go back again, guys. So this isn't handling pressure. This is applying pressure. And I'll do this afternoon. But this takes away, if you want a face guard, this takes away all screening action. Now, if this guy just goes this way, you just stay with him, right? Okay, so let's do that, guys. Try to get the ball on bounce. Try to set a screen. Your only job is for you guys to come together shoulder to shoulder. If they switch sides, automatic switch. If they go same side, you guys try to deny. You're trying to deny. Don't let it touch. Okay, come on back. Good job. Okay, now you be going this way. Okay, yeah. Okay? It's all right. Sometimes in Winnipeg they have different things, right? Maybe they go a different way in Winnipeg, right? Okay? So now hold it. Stop. Get in a stance. Come on. get in a stance. Like your job, you got one job. If he cuts this side, he doesn't touch. If they screen and they you guys go shoulder to shoulder, automatic switch, he doesn't touch. He doesn't touch. Well, good job, 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 great job, great job. You all right? Okay, see how simple that is? Shoulder to shoulder, allow no touch. Okay? Now I want to show you a way to get open. That I never have two people. When we attack pressure, I never have two people here. Just for that reason. If a team is good and they're well coached, they are going to take away any screening action instantly, right? So I always have one. So give me a person here. So just one guy. You guys are off for a second. Okay. Just add this to your offense as far as getting open. Have a rule. So the moment you get one step outside the foul line, the key extended, you automatically, I'm going to tell you, the moment you get right to that key, you go opposite direction. So you're going this way, and then you're going to go up to the moment you're going this way. Okay? Okay? You deny him like crazy. You can't throw over top. Okay, let's go. Okay. Okay, go again. Okay, now if you notice there, here was your cut. Here's the rule. As soon as you haven't got the ball here, it's an automatic cut here. Automatic. And what's your first name again?
Daniel.
Daniel, what Daniel did is he came here and he did this cut. Woo! A banana cut, right? And that banana cut isn't what caused the turnover. The turnover was caused by just a terrible pass 15 feet behind him, right? Yeah, that's your bad, right? So that's all right. You had a tough guy defending you here, so it was tough to throw over this guy, right? Okay, so I love you guys. You guys were great yesterday. I have fun. You gotta have fun. I mean, if you don't have fun when you're coaching and the kids don't have fun, right? Like you just gotta have fun. That's what life's about. Right? And you can have fun and teach at the same time. And you can have fun without being demeaning and that sort of stuff. I don't think these guys, I get them for a couple more hours tonight. I'm going to kill them when I get them over to another gym tonight. Okay? So, you can go either way, just get open. We're playing. Okay, go again. Now you got to hit him. You got to hit him right away. When he's open, let me take your spot. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's go again. If you get to that cone, you're going the other direction. Woo! There's no banana cuts. So, Daniel, okay, use your quickness. Watch. You come here. Like, just think. If he's overplaying you, he's that way. So automatically you just swim over and you just throw the ball to space. Okay? So let's go. Do that. Okay? Let's do that. Come hard. Okay? Yeah, I think if you attack with a one guard front and you teach kids that at a certain point in the floor, they automatically back cut and you teach your inbounder that, you'll have great success entering the ball. The moment you start bringing three or four people to it, it's trouble. Okay, all right, everybody get up. We need a ball and a partner. Okay, now we're going to talk about how to deal with traps and all those types of things. All right, so guys, let's partner up so you're facing the coaches. Quick, we've only got 39 minutes left. All right. So, what we're going to work on is we're going to work on like a very serious retreat drill. So, you're all going to get to about the cone. Let's pretend that's a line all the way across. And here's what you have to do. You're going to come here, and this represents somebody coming at you, a trap. You have to turn your head and feet backwards, and you have to keep your chin on your shoulder, and you throw the ball back out to the white line. So it's not the regular retreat dribble. It's not this. It's not where you come back here and you bounce back and square up. You are trying to escape pressure. So it's here. You turn here so you can still see basket and man, and you throw the ball out and you sprint back there like this. And get once you get to the line here, square up, keep the ball alive. Okay, everybody try that. Okay, let's go. Okay? Take the ball back with the same hand that you dribble with. Okay, let's go. Okay. Now, you guys are doing this. You guys are coming back like this. I want you to come back like this. We are on a dead sprint. Our shoulders and head are facing there. We are throwing the ball out. All we can see is the man chasing us. Okay, let's go. Speed. Gotta keep your shoulder on your chin. Go. Keep your shoulder on your chin. Get back. Okay, now, when you throw it back, when you get here, okay, it's not a pullback. When you get here, you throw the ball out. Like, you literally throw it back that way. Okay, let's go. See, keep chin. Throw it out. That's it. Crevice face. Once you get back to the white line, square up, keep the ball alive. Go. Keep your chin. Head on your chin. Let's go. Get back. You gotta get back quick. Throw it back, go. You gotta see, when you go back, when you throw it back, you're chasing it, but your chin is on your shoulder right here. Okay, go. Cover ground. Square up. Good job. Let's go again. New guys. Cover ground. Square up. Good. Go again. Go. Cover ground. Good. Okay, now let's go left then. Go. Cover ground. Get your chin on your shoulder. Go. Cover ground. Throw it back. Good job. That's it. Woo! Somebody told me you're a point guard. Is that right? How tall are you? 6'4"? It's good to have 6'4" point guards. Okay, do that again. Watch how quickly, Emmanuel, watch how quickly he gets back and watch how quickly he squares. Go. Okay, like that covers a lot of, yeah, you know what? They're not going to call that. Maybe in Manitoba, right? But, hey, I see going like this. Hey, they're not calling that. But in order to avoid that, go again, Emmanuel. Instead of going like this, when you get here, just throw it back. Okay, go. Just throw it back. That's it. Good. Okay, so that is a great way to escape pressure, right? But now you got to build it up. You know what? You don't really have to take notes. I got great notes with fast draw diagrams and like I want you just to kind of absorb, maybe put down some details. You'll get great notes on all my presentations. I said yesterday, for the first 20 years I went to kid, Drew's presentation this morning, I'm trying to write notes. He goes through 5 screening actions in 15 minutes, right? And if I don't go right back to the hotel and write that stuff down, I forget the details, right? So you'll get all the details in the notes. All right, so now we gotta break it down. So get in groups of 3, guys. Groups of 3. All right? Now we got to teach this. So get me a guy on the white line. Get me a guy here. Get me a guy in the middle and get it here. Okay. So let's put the balls on that side. That's fine. Okay. So now... Okay, so watch that ball behind you. Let's use the whole court. So let's go sideline. Okay, now you guys got to be, I want you guys more middle. You guys got to have space to go. You guys got to have space to go. So move up a bit. Move up a bit, guy. You're going to have to go backwards. Move up, move up. Okay. Inside the way. Okay, so you're gonna attack him. You're going to go back like we just did. Okay, so you're bouncing. You're going to come forward. And then I'm going to run at you. Now, cover his face back. Okay? Okay, now square up when you get back here. Okay? And you're going to run at his non-ball shoulder. This is, we're guided defense. So you're running, you're chasing out on a closeout on him on his non-ball shoulder. Now what you're doing, once you get back, you stutter, and then now you're going to explode out to about here. You're going to pass to Emmanuel, I forget your name, Shamar, you're going to pass to Emmanuel, and then you're going to attack him. You're going to dribble and then get back. Okay, so let's go back again. That's what it looks like. Okay, now this is guided. So the first phase of this is we're going opposite the ball so the ball handler gets some confidence, right? Your only job, guys, on ball is to get back as quickly as you can, keep your chin on your shoulder, and get squared up with your feet ready to go and explode, and almost be in the track stance that Drew was talking about today, right? And then you're going to explode about here. You're going to chest pass to Emmanuel. You're going to drive at them. They're coming at you. Then you got to get back, and then you go there. When he goes, let's walk through it. Okay, so you're going back with him. Okay. Now you're attacking his shoulder. Let him just delay your attack just a bit. Okay. Now go. You go. Okay. You stay. Okay. You hit Emmanuel right now. Emmanuel, come right at him hard. Man, go to this shoulder. Get back. Delay a little bit. Attack. Good. Okay. You hit him. Okay. Everybody got the drill? Okay. Now. Key things: chin on shoulder, head and shoulders facing this way, and throw the ball back. And once you get back there, square up. Okay, let's go. Get back in a hurry. You gotta attack him. Okay, you gotta attack him. Good job. Good job. Okay. You gotta dribble at him, pull him back, attack. Hit him right now. Dribble at him, okay? Okay, hold up a second. Guys, once you pass, delay for a second. So, if I'm coming across here and I pass to you, okay, now dribble towards me, and now I'm gonna attack you. Now get back, and when I come here, I'm attacking this shoulder so you can get by. Okay, so delay just a bit. Okay, let's go. Pull it back, get there quick. Attack. Don't go wide. Go right by his shoulder. Oh, you all right? Yeah, man. Okay, good job. Attack. Go back. Attack him. Good job. Don't go wide. Go right by his shoulder. Go right side. Okay, attack him. Good job. Okay. Good job, guys. Okay, now the next extension of this. You all right, Emmanuel? Okay. The next extension of this is now you're going to attack the ball side shoulder. Okay? So Emmanuel's coming at you. Okay, now we attack. Get back, Emmanuel. Now we're attacking ball side shoulder. Okay? Now we're going to get you to do a quick crossover through the legs. When you go by, you have to keep him on your back. So once you go by, bang, get him here. Bang, get him there. Okay, whatever you feel like, right? But you can't let him get back in the play. You're gonna let him cross over. You're not gonna deflect the crossover. Same drill, but now attack the ball. Let's go. Attack the ball, hard. Okay, let's go. Attack it. Good job. No, you can't go same side. You got to cross over. You can go through the legs or between, roll over, cross over. Good job. Okay. Good job. Get him. Come on. Good job. Let's go. Attack. You guys got to cover more space when you're getting back. Get back. Attack. Good job. Get back. Attack. Good job. Let's go. Good job. Attack. Good job. Attack. Good job. Don't go wide. Okay, hold on a second, guys. With this drill, how many guys we got here today? 12? Okay, so you got everybody in your team going. Everybody's handling pressure. Everybody's handling the ball. Everybody's passing the ball, right? So I really believe you have to do that. I don't believe you can have players that are specialized, right? I just post, right? I'm a point guard. I had a kid tell me the other day, I'm a shooting guard. What does that mean? Right? Does that mean that you only shoot? Like, is it like a hockey? Can we put you on a line change, right, when we have the ball, right? So you got to be an all-out player. So any questions on that drill? Now, as you progress in that drill, you play it live. So you're not going to be able to cross the ball over against good defense. It's going to have to be through your legs, behind your back, roll over, crossover that we talked about yesterday, all those types of things. But you build it up. And you start with no defense, guided defense, live defense. All right? Okay, the next thing that you have to do when you're handling pressure is, I call it a pick a line. It's an attack line. So get me two guys the same size. Let go of you two guys right here. Guys, just, you can grab a seat for a second. Thank you. Okay? So let's pick the red line. Or let's say we're going this way. Let's pick the white line. Okay? If you are being harassed by a defender, okay, check me, okay, you have to be able to lean into him, okay, with your shoulder and your arm and not get pushed off your line, okay? Defensively, your job, when I talk about trapping and running jumped this afternoon, your job is to push me off this line and get me to the sideline, right? So now I want you to go slow. You're on offense. And your job is to get to that end of the volleyball line, okay, the court, and not get pushed off this line. Now go slow. You have to put your shoulder and your forearm in him. So it looks like this. You are battling, and you're battling trying to push him off this line. Okay? So so you gotta be way more physical than that. Okay? I'm a tough guy. I lift. Okay? Okay? So you gotta be really physical. Okay? Now don't be in a hurry. The drill is just for you to learn how to handle pressure, not panic, but not get pushed off your line. Okay, let's go. Head up. Okay, good job. Okay, now switch it around. You're a very nice guy. You're a nice guy. Hey, I don't want you to be as nice. Okay, so I don't want you to get pushed off your line. Slow, go slow, shoulder. Okay, slow. Get your shoulder and arm into him. Okay, good. Keep going. Okay. All right. Okay, switch around. Okay, now, give me two new guys. Be similar size, two new guys. Okay, same thing. Okay. So now be slow. Get your arm and shoulder into him. Maintain your line. Be really slow though. Go. Okay. It's a very difficult drill. Okay. These guys are doing it well. Okay. Good. Okay. Switch around. Okay. Let's go. Okay. Oh, slow. Just slow. Maintain the ball. Slow. That's it. Good job. You have to be able to handle pressure And I'll tell you, here's an offensive drill we do. Guys, come at center here. Let me diverge just for a sec. Okay, so here's what I want you to do. Ask these guys how tough this, you guys are right at center. How tough this drill is, because they're huffing and puffing, okay? So you're at center, okay? And basically, I want you, okay, you have to go foul line extended, okay? When you get foul line extended, you have to either go through your legs behind your back or roll over, crossover. Go slow, and I'm going to foul you the whole way down. So I'm going to foul you like this. Slow. Okay? Okay, I'm going to foul you the whole way. I'm going to have you like this. Go. Okay, let's go. Okay, now I'm going to foul you here, and then, okay, now I'm going to let you go for a shot. Okay, just do that to him. Okay? So this is handling pressure too, right? You got to be able to get into offense. All right, let's go. Good job. Let him go. Okay, shot. Okay, so that's just another drill that you can use. Try to make everything way more difficult. So this is just to get your person off the line. Now, it's called lean and loop. So get me three guys. So, we're going to have you, Emmanuel, you're going to trap in a second. Okay, so you're in offense. I wish I had the mic here. You can't have a mic, but he's dying, right? So, like, I know these drills are good because he's physically tired because it's a lot of energy and a lot of, you have to be strong with the ball and that sort of stuff. Okay, now you're going to be a trap coming down this side. You're still going to be an offense. You're an offense. You're coming from there. So let's say you're at a little bit, okay. This is what happens, right? 2-2-1, 1-2-1-1. This is called lean and loop. You gotta lean into him, just like we just did, okay? And you're gonna play kind of like 50% right now, okay? So like be kind of more square, yeah. Be more square. Let me get into you. Okay, now, you're going to come at me, okay, and instead of doing the long pullback that we demonstrated before, this is called mini pullback. When you get to this position, you'd like to have the ball outside his outside shoulder right away. And it's a lateral pullback, so it's a mini pullback. You're here from this lean and loop, and you get the ball back here, and immediately when he comes, you attack his outside shoulder. Okay? So that's what you're doing. So it's called lean and loop. Come down, pull back, attack. Good job. Foul. Okay? I've played in Manitoba. Okay? That's automatic. If that's Winnipeg. By the way, Tanya does a great job with the girls. She, like, the girls love playing for her. I coached UVic women for 1 year, and I bet you I watched 50 tapes of a run and jump. I have no idea what she does, right? I haven't got a clue. I haven't got a clue of the rules, haven't got a clue on the rotations, haven't got a clue on what they do in that run and jump. All I know is they cause a lot of grief. I don't even think they know what they do, right? Okay? I don't believe they really know what they do, but they do it well, okay? So, same drill now. Lean and loop, attack the weak outside shoulder. Okay, boom. Okay, come on back. You got to pull back a little farther than that. You got to attack harder, Emmanuel. So start at center. Okay, let's go. Pull it back. Okay, you're in trouble. Okay. Okay. Now, if he does that, what would you do? Oh, no, let's go through that again. If he does that, come down. And he. Okay. Look it. Okay, you see that? You can drive a semi-trailer through that, right? So if you see that much of a split, right, on this, immediately if you see that, immediately throw the ball through first, low, and go. Emmanuel, right now, you're trying to trap him, okay? So pick the ball. I'm going to throw the ball in. You got to get open. So I would always do this with getting open first. Okay, let's go. Good job. Good job. Come back. Let's go again. Let's go. Don't let them split you. Okay? Let's go. Get open. Good job. Let's go. Daniel. I have a basement suite in my house. You want to come to BC? Okay, I was just asking. Okay, let's go. Get open. Slow, slow, slow. Okay, good job, good job. Okay, now I want to go. I want you to go slow. Lean and loop. Let him trap you. You'd be a difficult trap. Okay, ready? Let's go. Okay, now stop. You're dancing with me. Right? Don't dance with me. Okay, now, for this drill, you're going to let him get the ball on this side. Okay? Okay, slow. Trap. Okay, now, Emmanuel, when you come up the trap, you're coming up to trap. And then the two of you are chasing the trap. So when you come here, we're chasing the trap. Okay? And that's when you don't want to get pinned too far to the sideline. Okay? So you got to have some space to work. Okay, so get open again. Good job. Daniel's very good with the ball. He recognizes things. So that's called lean and loop on the line, then lean and loop against the trap. Now the next thing you want to do is you want to do identify weak defender. So get me three new guys. Three new guys. Okay, thanks guys, you guys can sit. Okay, so defensively, rank yourself right now. One, two, or three?
One.
Okay. Okay, one being the best defender, two being the second best defender, three being the worst defender. So they put you three. So if he's on defense, we're attacking him. Okay? You got to know that. Okay, so ball's over here. Okay. Ball's over here. You have the ball. You guys over there. Ball's right here. You've got the ball. You're going this way. Okay, back up just a bit. Okay, you're going to dribble in to this double team. Then you're going to pull it back, mini pull back, and you got to attack the shoulder of the weakest defender. Who's the weakest defender? Number three. He identified himself as being a stiff. Okay? All right? So let's go. Hard. Nah, come on back, come on back. You guys are playing live D. Okay? You know, if he's the weakest defender, you better not be going in with your right hand. Okay? You better be going in with your left hand, because when you pull back, right, that mini pull back, right, you want to be attacking his shoulder. Okay, so you guys start a little bit farther back. Okay? Let's go. Pull it back, pull it back. No, that's stop. Come on back, come on back. You got to pull it back. You got to draw him in. This is really important. Because if you don't pull back, you just go like this. Right? Like, you're not getting him. You got to pull him back. We're trapping. Okay, attack me. Bang, now I can attack. You have to pull him back. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's go again. Got to handle the ball. Let's go, let's go. Okay, now, I want to show you, let's do it this way. You're making a critical mistake, so let's go. So you're going to come this way. You got the ball right there on the white line. You guys are here. So, first name here?
Shamar.
So Shamar never really engages. Here's what he does. He comes here, right? But he stops about here, right? So, like, if you want to attack pressure, go at these guys, and then when you have your mini pullback, bang, now you have a track start. you're giving these guys all the advantage. You're like, you got to go into that guy and have confidence that you can give it, create enough space to get a, pull it back. Good job. That's it. Good. Okay, come on back again. Good job. Okay, attack them hard. Pull it back. Mini pull back. Attack the outside shoulder of the weakest guy. Good. Okay, so get your players to identify the weak persons in the weak people in the trap. And that doesn't, you're not being mean, you just, it's just, that's the way it is. Okay, now lean and loop. So you're right there. Get on his shoulder. Now we got to work on splits. So I'm you for a second. Okay, so lean into me, shoulder, contain the ball. And now he's coming to trap. Pull it back. Mini pull. And you see a space. The ball's got to go through super low. Okay, ball's got to go through first. Okay, put the ball through first. Low. Ball's got to be about his sock level. Okay, so let's go live. You take my spot. Okay, pardon me? You're going to let him split, yeah. Okay, let's go. That ball's way too high. Like, you got to throw the ball through. So if I'm here, can you just catch it over there for a second? Okay, so I come in here, I pull it back, attack me, guys. When I split, the ball's got to be like both there, and I pick it up going through here. Okay, so let's try one more time. Let's go. Pull it back. That's it. Good job. Okay, let's go one more time. Good. Everybody get a basketball, quick. Line up behind me, guys. 6 or 7 balls, line up behind me, okay? Okay, so another drill you need against pressure is you need a rollover crossover. So what I want you to do, I want you to turn your shoulders and your hips, and you're literally coming right at me, and you're throwing the ball out, and you're going to pick it up almost at the white line. Okay? You just throw it out. You're going with speed. Throw it out. There you go. Beautiful. Next side. Go. Throw it out. Okay, good job. Go. Throw it out. Good. Throw it out. Good. Get it lower. Throw it out. Good job. Throw it out. There you go. Good. Throw it out. Good. Okay, now hold it. Stay. Okay, go back. Okay, now throw it out, but don't make it quite as wide. Don't throw it out that wide. Throw it farther ahead. Okay, let's go. Throw it out. Good job. Okay? Throw it out. There you go. Good job. So, if you are being guarded, Emmanuel, and you beat your guy, and a guy is either here or a guy's coming up to trap, you don't want to have to slow down. So you're going to come full speed at me. It's called a rollover crossover. Okay, let's go. You don't slow down for 1 second. Good. Now, that's just a crossover. Got to create space. There you go. Cross it. Throw it over. That's it. Good. Throw it over. Good. Throw it over. Good. Throw it over. Good job. Excellent. Good. Okay? Teach all your kids that. Teach every player you have that. Do you guys see how much distance you cover on that? You see what speed you're going at? You don't slow down for a second, right? Okay, now, come on down, guys. Okay, get me 2 guards outside the 3. Give me a ball, and get me 3 defenders. Give me 3 defenders inside the 3. Okay? 3 defenders inside the 3. Okay. Who are my 2 guards? 1, 2. And you got the 3 defenders. Okay, here's the rules of the game. You guys have to come inside the 3. I'm going to throw you the ball. Okay? Your job is to keep the ball alive for as long as you can. We always have to have the ball trapped and an interceptor. So, if I throw the ball, come inside the 3. Okay, now, the out of bounds is now the 3-point line. The out of bounds is now the three-point line. You have to get open. You have to handle pressure. Now, this one, you're going to have to use mini stuff, right? So you come at, he's the weakest defender. You get by him, you got to get open, bang. Then you got to get to space. One of you guys got to get to a trap. Attack the trap, okay? So everybody understand the drill? Okay. So this is a great drill for your guards. Great drill if you are a trapping team. Okay, get in stance, boys. This is hard. Okay, so you guys want deflections or steals. The only way you can get on offense is get deflections or steals. You guys, if you can keep the ball alive for 10 minutes, too bad on them. Okay, ready? Get inside the three. Attack him. Two guys on the ball. Two guys. Attack. Attack and move. Boom. Okay? Next five. Give me new five guys. Quick. Okay. Be outside the three. You got to come into the three. Okay? Ready? So, my fault. Let's go. Go. Spacing. Don't have three guys on the ball. Come on, double team. Don't pick the ball up. Go again, guys. If you pick the ball up, you're toast. You're history. Your dad's not even driving you home if you pick the ball up. Okay? Ready? Go. Attack. Good job. Gotta cover. Try not to turn your back on your partner. You pick the ball up again. I can hear your dad's truck going. Boom. Okay? Now you got to keep the ball alive. Okay? And I know you can handle. I saw you yesterday. What's your last name? Kylik? Yeah. Mr. Kylik, we'll see you. Okay? So come on. If you pick it up this time, the truck is gone. Okay, let's go. Ready? Play. Let's go. Trap him. Let's go get after him. Got it. Good job. Out of bounds. See ya. Okay? Okay, that's one. Now, here's just a different version of it. I got 6 minutes left. Wow. They don't give me enough time. Okay? All right. You guys are saying this guy has had way too much time. Okay, give me three offensive players and two defensive players. Three offensive players outside the three. Okay? Two defensive players. Who are my offensive players? Okay. This is a reverse twist. Offense, you have 4 seconds maximum to get a shot off. You can't shoot on the first pass. Okay? From me. Okay? You can dribble. You're allowed 2 passes. Okay? But you can't shoot on the first pass from me. So you guys, you're not trapping. You're just trying to contest shots. So you gotta, and don't settle for all just necessarily outside shots. Everybody ready? Okay, play. Good job. Let's go again. Now, hey, that might have been longer than 4 seconds. You can dribble. Okay, ready? Hey guys, your job is to not give up a layup and contest every shot. You got an impossible job. Okay, let's go. Okay, now, Daniel, as I told you yesterday, your girlfriend's probably going home with somebody else. Once again, you got to the rim, but what happened? You were fouled, yeah. Yeah, this is not a foul, even in Manitoba, okay? Okay, so, you gotta score. Now, use your size. Take them underneath, reverse, okay? Let's go. Get ready. Go. That's a great play. Nice job. Okay? So there's a good drill offense. Okay, now get me a guy out of bounds being guarded. Get me an offensive guy here. You go offense?
Yeah.
Okay, your offense here. Front, have him face guarded and somebody behind. Somebody behind. Okay, guys, get off the court. Okay, you need a ball. Okay. Okay, so now, You got to work in situations where, like, you, this is very tough for you to get open. You would like to force the ball to this side. You guys would ideally like to force the ball strong side. You know what I mean by that? Okay. But you can go either way. Okay, Connor, you can go either way. Okay. Go again. Okay, now, you got to, Connor's a strong guy, but you got to be a physical beast too, right? So, like, your job is like, he can't get by you, right? You know he can't throw over top, right? So he has to come. So you just can't let him, you got to be physical with him, and you can't let him get open. You got to be creative, use your strength. And once you catch, it's 3-on-2 or 2-on-3 up the court. So we're trapping every pass, and you're getting into the next passing lane, right? Or you might trap, and you'd be in the next passing lane, okay? So let's go. We gotta trap the ball! Okay, so Connor, your dad's already at home watching TV, okay? But I want to show you something. Watch. It's way better for you to get an 8 or a 10 second call, right, than for you to make that pass. So I want you to take a deep breath. I'll drive you home, okay? Okay? And I want you to, we're going to go again, and I want you to slow down. Hey, I was talking to Dan. He says you're a really good player. Okay? So let's go. Slow down. Okay, go again. That's all right. Now, when I say, okay. It's all right. It's bad lighting in the gym. Okay? All right. Take a deep breath. Okay? This is tough. Okay? Now, make your face more definitive. Right? Like, they're all sloppy. It's like you're Gumby. Okay? Okay? It's straight line cut. Let's go. There you go. Hey! Your dad's going home too. Okay? When he makes a great cut, he's got to get the ball, right? And you can't give him the ball the baseline. He was open right here, right? The ball's got to be delivered. Okay? Last time. Let's go. Okay, one last thing. And I didn't get a chance to talk to you. You all right? That's twice you got smacked today. Okay, so with these guys, I'm going to do fast break at the CP session. We never want to trap me, guys. Trap me. These passes are deflected every single time, right? You got to get down. Right? You got to be short and chop with the ball. You got to try to split, right? You cannot go over the top or the ball's going to be defended. I mean, tipped or deflected, right? So don't use your dribble. Stay low. Be aggressive with the ball. Thanks, guys. Hey, how about a hand for these guys again? Okay. I have a bunch more drills that you'll get with the package. I just didn't get through them all. If you have any questions, I'm here till my next presentation at 1. Is it 1? Okay, 1. And as I said yesterday, like, these guys are an example of how far Basketball Manitoba has come, and it's because of you. Biggest conference in Canada, most growth and most improvement of any of the provincial teams in Canada, right? You guys should be very proud. I am very fortunate to be asked to speak at this, right? And I've been doing this for 41 years. This is a great game. I have met great people. I wouldn't change one thing. Not one thing. I had my kids at the gym with me all the time. That means they're around the best kids in the school, right? If you are coaching and teaching, you have the best job in the world. I could have retired with a full pension, I think, 9 years ago, right? I work for about 27 cents a day in BC right now, right? And it's worth every minute of it, right? Because it's the best job. And I think if you do something you love, that's the joy in life. So thank you very much, and I'll see you at 1:00.